Alrighty, y'all. So I wanted to do this video because obviously I think we're gonna get into a point where newer players are gonna start coming in, especially with the collab, and then obviously anniversary is coming up. And I'm gonna make more of these like updated type of videos closer to the anniversary where we're gonna get a bunch of new characters. But in today's video, I want to talk about characters that I think you should have on your account to be successful throughout your Nikkei journey, right? Like characters that are like must-haves, you need to have. Not necessarily a tier list, but characters that you need to have, right? Because a lot of people, obviously, I guess they don't understand the value of a character. And I kind of want to like get you guys to understand the value of a character through these characters. Now, there's not a lot of characters I'm going to be showing you guys here. I'm showing you guys a total of 15 characters here. And some of them that I do feel like are needed aren't going to be shown here just because I'll explain in a second. But essentially, I guess I can explain now. Alice and Privity are two of them that I would say, but they're free characters. So you're going to get them regardless. So those are the only two you're not going to see here for anybody wondering. But yeah, let's start this video. Make sure you guys subscribe and like. We're on the road to 19,000 and then 20,000 by the end of the year. So if you guys are new here and you find this helpful in any type of way, subscribe. But let's talk about it. So first things first, I think everybody knows that you need to have Red Hood. Red Hood is easily a character that you need to have. Not because she's like a bird. 1, 2, and 3. Well, that is the reason. She's just that good, right? This character is literally so good, being a burst 1, 2, and 3, because no matter what you have on your account, she can fill in any of those roles. Not to mention, if you want her as a support, she's a pretty good support. If you want her as a burst 2 tank, she's actually a decent, like, obviously she's not tanking as a burst 2, but she is like, at the same time, not gonna like let you down. Like every shot, she's healing a boatload from her shots as her burst 2. Her burst 2 isn't that great, but if I wanted her for the specific reason of, okay, let me heal or whatever, and I believe she taunts as well on her burst 2. It's been so long. Yeah, she taunts as well, HP potency increase, like all these things. If you want these things, then you can use her there. But she basically fills up the roles. Her burst 1 is a massive support. Her burst 3 is insane DPS. Her burst 2 is somewhat of sustain. Not the greatest sustain in the game, but it is actually like somewhat decent. Not anything tanking related, whatever. But this character is really freaking good just because you have her as a burst 1, 2, and 3 to fill in any slots on. She basically works with any team you have, right? Because if you're missing out on certain characters, her being burst 1, 2, and 3, she literally just fills out that role, right? And she's good at burst 1 and 3, somewhat okay at burst 2. So I would say Red Hood is the character that everyone needs to have on their account. This is a character you need to have on your account. Next is Crown. These are the top two characters I would say you need to have on your account. Crown is so freaking good, it's crazy. This is the one, if not the only character, I want to say, honestly, Crown is the only character in the game that makes it that whatever characters you're using, they are going to be a lot better than if you were not to have Crown on the same team, right? If I was to only have Soleen as a DPS and I only use Soleen, I wasn't going to get far, right? But if I have Crown and Soleen, Soleen is going to do so much more than what she was doing without Crown. That's just how much of a buff Crown gives to the team, right? She has a lot of attack buffs, a lot of reload buffs. She does give some defense buff as well. She gives a shield, a lot of attack damage buff, like a lot of these. She's literally making it that characters hit harder, and she also is making it that characters are protected with the shield and stuff like that. Not to mention Crown herself, because obviously she's giving insane buffs. She herself is buffing her own damage as well. So I would say Crown is definitely a character you need to have on your account. That's just guaranteed. Modernia, fantastic character till this day. You need to have her on your account. This character literally fits on any single team. She is kind of a off burst rotation burst 3 character. I want to say it's a character you don't need to use her burst skill, right? You do not need to use Modernia's burst skill for her to work at all. You do not need to use her burst skill to work for her to work at all, right? If you use her burst skill, it's great, and her burst skill is really helpful, right? Basically being a controllable AoE, that's what I like to call it. It's a massive radius where she can cover a lot of the screen for 15 seconds with unlimited ammo. Not to mention she gives herself a lot of buffs, some crit damage buff, attack buff, hit rate buff. She gives herself these things, right? But this character is just a perfect off burst rotation burst 3 character, and she's just so like universal, it's crazy. I would say you need to have Modernia. Litter, till this day, one of the best characters, and I would say you need to have her on your account. When it comes to the go-to burst one option, Litter still stands at the very top of that, right? There's a lot of other good burst one options, but Litter is by far the best burst one option till this day. She has cooldown reduction. I don't really consider too much of these buffs, but she does have ammo capacity, charge, crit damage, and attack buffs depending on how many times you use her burst skill. But she has cooldown reduction. She actually covers cover HP by a decent amount, 42% at level 6, for example, to two allies. She's very helpful, and then a massive attack buff for all allies every burst rotation. It only is for 5 seconds, right? But it is still very good, right? Just the whole combination of Litter as a burst one, I still feel like is unmatched. And I would easily say you need to have this character on your team. Like, she is the go-to option for burst one, like the best by far. And then obviously Scarlet is another character, the Black Shadow version specifically, fantastic. Just clearing the game when it comes to damage and stuff like that, fantastic. You cannot die. She's fantastic. Her percentages are insane. 200, 500, and 250%. 250%, 500%, 750%. And this is basically after a total of 9 normal attacks, you get all this going. But when you use her burst skill, not only is her attack increased by 115% and her charge damage is increased by 150%, but this, rather than it being 9 normal attacks for all this to proc, you only need 3 normal attacks for all this to proc. She is easily like the best clearer in the game, I would say. I would say this Scarlet right here is the best clearer in the game. She's going to clear mobs. She's going to clear bosses. She is the best clearer in the game. Like, if you want a go-to DPS, that's this Scarlet right here. This is the go-to DPS. You need to have her on your account. That's just how it is. Now, we're going to get more into the, like, supports of the game. Tia is someone I would say you need to have on your account, but I wouldn't say have Tia on your account unless you have Naga. Out of the two, I would say Naga you definitely want to have on your account. She's just that good of a support. Like, when she came out, she was really just a support to Tia. But as time went on, she just became so much better as a support. It's wild, right? Tia and Naga, this combination is literally just, it's like so broken. But the good thing is Naga's best partner as well, it's not even Tia anymore, her best partner is with Crown, right? So you literally have options. You can run Crown without Naga and then put Naga back on the team with Tia, or you can run Naga with Crown. But these characters are insane, like just insane buffers, right? You have obviously cover rebuild, like cover heals, you have shields, a lot of tanking from Tia's part, some attack damage buff, but her main thing is really more tanking. And then when it comes to Tia, you have a lot more just damage buffs, right? She's healing, she's giving damage, she's just, that's mainly her thing. She's giving damage. She does recover cover HP as well, but her main thing is she's giving you a lot of damage as well. So having both of these two on the same team, especially since they're meant for each other, is really good. But like I said before, you don't need to have them together because Naga works with a lot of other characters. Naga healing procs up Crown, and then her giving a lot of damage buffs, you can kind of understand why they're great together, her and Crown. Rouge, Blanc, Noir. I would say all three of these characters. You don't need to have all three of these characters. You just need to have Blanc. This is a character you must have. This character is a must-have. I'm going to talk about the other two in a second. This is a character you must have. She is so broken. She is so broken. The only thing that's a problem for Blanc is that you need specific characters for her to work completely, but she is broken. She is literally the only character I want to say, not really the only one, but I would say she's the best at it at this point. In terms of healing, she's healing you every second. After you use her burst skill the first time, she's healing you every second of the game. And that's why she's so crazy to me. She does have a shield as well, which I don't really like ever look too much at it, but it is useful there. She does have indomitability, which is keeping a character on your team alive from dying, especially if they have like the lowest HP, right? So if I put her up with a tank and a tank is taunting and stuff like that, this indomitability is going to keep that tank alive and make it that tank cannot die, right? Because she's also giving max HP, right? She does have damage taken increased to all enemies as well. But I feel like my favorite thing about this Blanc is the fact that she's literally healing you every single second. The only problem is that you have to have her with somebody from this squad, being Rouge or Noir. I would say now Rouge is the go-to, just because Rouge also has cooldown reduction, which I think cooldown reduction is something that you want to have on your account. Not to mention Rouge is giving pretty decent attack damage buffs, like just attacking buffs or damage buffs, and then she also is giving you a lot of HP and damage reduction, right? It's a lot of damage HP to specific characters, unless you're using her burst skill, then she gives it to all allies. But she is fantastic. This is a fantastic character. I would say you would want to have these two on the same team. When it comes to Noir is still a fantastic character as well. She has a permanent attack buff if her HP is above 70%, ammo capacity, reload, and then AoE with hit rates and stuff like that. I wouldn't say she's as useful as Rouge, if you want me to be honest. I know that might sound so crazy to say, because Noir has been literally like the go-to pick for a long time, but that's only because she was the only go-to pick when it came to her being paired up with Blanc. But now with Rouge in the game, I wouldn't say this is a, like, you would still want to have her on your account. Noir is still like broken. Don't get it twisted. But now you have other options. That's what I'm trying to get at, basically. And then for the last five, I would say D-Killer Wife, fantastic character. Insane cooldown reduction. After 8, you know, full charges, 7 seconds down, she's giving a pierce damage buff. She's giving attack damage buff. She's really giving damage buffs. But her greatest thing is the fact that she has a 7-second cooldown reduction buff, right? Or at least ability. Her and Rouge both have this skill, and it's very good because that allows 40-second cooldown characters to be able to burst every burst rotation, right? So having these characters on your account means that if, let's say, the only good burst 2 character I have is Polly, but Polly's on a 40-second cooldown. If I have D-Killer Wife, or if I have Rouge on my team, after 8 normal attacks, constantly happening throughout that like whole time period of the going into the full burst ending, going back into a burst skill, you're going to be able to use Polly's burst skill again within that next burst rotation, despite being her being a 40-second cooldown character. So I would say D-Killer Wife is a must-have. Dorothy, I would still say, is a pretty good must-have. She is another go-to option for that burst one. Especially when it comes to just wanting to have additional DPS or even just bosses in general, right? I would say this character is a go-to. She has cooldown reduction. She has increased damage to parts. But her biggest thing, obviously, as we all know, is her brand effect, which is just chucking damage away from enemies, mainly bosses. So that's kind of her whole thing. She's like more of a bossing character, but she is another go-to burst one option, right? Summer Anise. Obviously, Summer Anise is still one of the best characters in the game. Let's not get it twisted. She does so much damage, and I think the best thing about this character is that her best partner is the free-to-play character Privity, who is also a part of this list, but like I said, you get it for free, so it's not really like, I don't know if I need to talk about them or not. Maybe I should, I don't know. But this character is just really freaking good. Really freaking good when you have her paired up with Privity. A lot of damage. She is supporting electric code characters. And that's going to talk about our next character. We're going to come back to Lamela, but Scarlet. Even though the Scarlet is still falling off, she's still pretty good DPS. I would say that's your main reason for putting her on your team. Like, getting this character because of her DPS. If you want me to be honest, would I choose this Scarlet over the other Scarlet? Probably not, if I had the option to choose between the two. That's a me thing. I know some people would. Because of her like insane AoE, I guess, for PvP or whatever. But this Scarlet is still very good, right? And same thing kind of goes for Ludmilla. Maybe Ludmilla's more of a reach. Like, I wouldn't say Ludmilla's a character you need to have, realistically, right? I wouldn't say she's more a character you need to have. Like, she's a very good freaking DPS, right? But I wouldn't say she's a character you need to have. Let me remove her. She's a character who's very good at DPS, but I wouldn't say you need to have her. I would say these characters are the ones you would need to have on your account. Let me remove Ludmilla. She's a very, because she's like nothing, she's no different than Ayn to me. Like, Ayn is also a character who's really good at DPS, but I wouldn't say you need to have Ayn unless you wanted a good DPS. But then again, you need to have these DPSs. Like, you need to have them. You're genuinely not gonna get through a lot of the content in the game if you don't have some of these specific characters. I'm just being honest with you guys. I know some people might tell you otherwise, but if you don't have a lot of these characters that I'm talking about in this video, it's gonna be very hard for you to get by the game. And I know that sounds crazy, but and let me ask you guys this question. If my team was this, right? Let's say my burst one. I'm going to put a team up, and you guys let me know in the comments down if I can beat the game with this team. Can I beat the game with this team? No, I probably cannot beat the game with this team, right? But the thing is, there's a lot of people who will probably only have access to a team like this, and that's kind of my point. But guess what? I can have a way better chance if I switch out this character for this. That's what I'm saying. I could have a lot better chance of beating majority of the stuff in the game with a comp like this, right? Where I put Crown on my team because of how much buff she's giving. Or heck, let's put back on that same team, but let's say this time I switched out Crown for Red Hood, right? I could probably get pretty good because Red Hood is on the team. Or if I switched out Red Hood for Scarlet, I could probably get far with just having these one specific character added onto these teams. That's kind of my whole point. So these are the characters, right? The 1, 2, 3, and then obviously the ones I showed you before I switched this around. Those are the characters I would say you need to have on your account, because those are the only characters that are really going to help you get somewhere, right? You don't have to have all of them, just you need to have some of these characters on your account. Like, that's the reality. But you guys, let me know what you think. It's your boys, the Yuxers, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next one. Let me know if you agree. Let me know who else you guys feel like you would need to have on your account. Like, I feel like there's a lot of people that I could have said you need to have on your account, but at the same time, I don't know if I would say they are needs. Like, Rapunzel's a very good healer. Would I say you need to have Rapunzel? Maybe back in the time, but now we have so many good healers that I wouldn't say you need to have her, right? So you guys let me know. It's your boys, the Yuxers. I'm gonna see you guys next one. I'm out. Peace.